Hello guys, welcome to this new video on the series of videos where I'm showing you how you can build a Flask text sentiment application. So if you remember, in the last class we have built a basic server where we rendered this string, which is nothing but an HTML representation, where we are writing an h1 tag and which is rendered by this server, and this server has one route. Okay, and so these are the things which we discussed in the last video, right? So in this video, what we want to do is, since if you see here that if I write all the HTML in this string, it can get a little bit trickier and messy. So what we want to do is, we want to have a separate HTML file where we can write all of our HTML, and we need to find a way or a mechanism by which we can render that page itself. Okay, so we want something like this. So if I want something like render, and here I can put the path of the file, whatever is the name of the file, index.html. that page will get rendered instead of this text. So in this video I'm planning to do that only. Okay, so before that, let's just render the page that we have built in the last class. So let's quickly run it, python main.py. So it is going to point us to the location, point us to the link, and that link is nothing but the link of localhost. So it's like a local server that we are building on our computer. So if I visit this link, and you can see that it has correctly rendered the h1 tag as a Flask application, right? Okay, so in this class, what we want in this video or in this class, what we want to do is, we want to see that how we can render an external HTML file. But before I do that, I would like to first make sure every one of you understand what is HTML, because I have assumed in the beginning of this series that you should not be familiar with any HTML or CSS. So I'll be discussing what are the components that you need to understand regarding HTML, right? So let's get started. Okay, so what is HTML? So this is the presentation regarding rendering external HTML files. Now in this, I would like to discuss what is HTML. Okay, so HTML is a way of organizing a web page. Now a web page is any page that you visit once you enter the URL of that page, and what you see in that page is a mixture of various things like HTML, CSS and JavaScript. But what I'm discussing here is HTML. HTML is a way of organizing the things. I mean, where something will be put on a web page. So if I visit a Google's homepage, then you can see that we have got these components for Gmail images, this little button, and then we have this component for the photo of the Google account. Right, so we have got this component for image, we have got this component for entering URL. So these are all things that has been accomplished using HTML. Now all of the styles, I mean where these components will be put and how these components will be colored and all these things will be done using CSS. But the way the ordering of all of these components is done by this HTML, right? HTML stands for hypertext markup language. It is a markup language, which is a language of organizing a web page, how our various components will be put on a web page, right? So you can view the HTML code for any web page by hitting Control Shift Enter. So if I hit Control Shift Enter here, you can see that in the elements section of the new window, you can see these codes that represent the HTML page. Now each component of this web page is known as tags. Now we have got this head tag, we have got this body tag, and inside this body tag we have got various other different types of tags like div tag, script tag, dialogue tag. You don't need to understand each of these tags as of now. You just need to understand what you are required to understand. I mean, I will be discussing those things in a little bit later. So right now you just need to you just need to understand that everything in a web page is made up of these tags. Okay, all right. So now, as we have discussed that everything in an HTML page is made up of tags. Now these tags can be of various other types, like we have got this A tag, we have got this P tag, and then we have got div, image, input tags. Now various type of tags are quite self-explanatory, like input tag. Input tag is used for taking an input from the user. Image tag is used for displaying an image. Like you can see here, this is a Google logo. This must have used a image tag, and we can also check whether this particular logo has been made using image tag or not by hovering our mouse on this logo and then right clicking to the inspect. We can see that this logo has not been made using image tag, it has been made using a div tag, because in HTML there are various different ways of doing a certain thing, so it doesn't necessarily have to be done using only one way. Okay, so and many more, no need to memorize, just visit this particular site. It is a reference of all the HTML tags that you might be using. So it is a wonderful resource. You can visit this particular resource, and you will be finding a list of all the HTML tags that you might use in this particular web. So you don't need to memorize all the HTML tags, you just need to be aware of these many number of tags that are available, but no need to memorize all the parameters and all. Okay, only those tags that you might need to use on a regular basis, only those number of tags that you need to remember. Okay, now again, tags in HTML can be of two types. First one is opening and closing tag, and then second one is self-closing tag. Now in the opening and closing tags, generally these type of tags are used to put some content in between. So in div tag, div stands for division, so it is kind of a section making tag, because in the div tag you can put various other different types of tag. Like say for example, you want to create a section for three images, so you can create a div tag with three image tag nested inside this div tag. This is an example of opening and closing tag, because for this we have to make a div opening tag, and then inside it we have to put all of our content that we want to put, and then we have to close this div tag using this. Similar to this, we have got this P tag, which stands for paragraph. So again, for the paragraph we can put any text inside this particular paragraph. Okay, now we have got another form of tag, which is known as self-closing tag. For example, A tag. A tags are used for putting hyperlinks. A tags are used for putting hyperlinks. Say for example, if I go to this particular web page, there might be some links. Like if I go here, you can see there that it points me to this address called www.google.com. So it might have used a tag for its structure. Okay, all right. So after we have understood what tag is, now we need to understand that each tag can have what is known as tag attributes. Now what do we mean by tag attributes? To understand what tag attributes mean, we need to we can study a tag called input tag. Now input tag has a parameter called type. Based on that type attribute, we can have various different types of tags. Say for example, I can have a input of type text, in which user can enter any text, or I can have an input of type number, where a user can enter any number, or I can have an input in which a user can upload any file. Okay, so I hope these things are quite self-explanatory. Okay, now we need to understand ki every web page, no matter where you no matter what type of URL you visit to, each web page has a root HTML tag. Now this root HTML tag can further be divided into two distinct type of tags called head tag and body tag. Whenever you visit a web page, what you see on that web page is comes under body tag. So whatever you are seeing on a web page comes under this body tag. Okay, but what goes inside this head tag? Inside this head tag, we put all of our files like CSS, JavaScript files. Okay, so I hope these two tags made sense to you. Every HTML, every web page is made up of these two tags. This HTML tag is known as root tag, which contains two tags, head and body. And this body can contain various type of tags like these one: a tag, p tag, div, image or input. Okay, now no need to memorize anything, just be aware that these things exist, and if any doubt arises, Google is your friend. Again, I am again and again mentioning this particular point, that you don't need to get overwhelmed by the amount of information that is available. You just need to understand what's going on under the hood, and how are different things working. So if you understand this, don't sweat yourself for unnecessary things. Just understand, and don't try to memorize anything. Okay, so I hope all of the things that I have discussed in this video made sense, and I'll be seeing you in the next video, where I will be putting all of these things to use. Thank you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and yeah, thank you. Have a nice day.